We are met this day to glorify God whose power sustains the world, to remember with thanksgiving those who lived and died in the service of our country, and to ask for God's help and blessing that we may be worthy of their sacrifice each day of our life. God is our refuge and our stronghold, a timely help in trouble. Those who look to the Lord will win new strength. They will soar as on eagle's wings. They will run and not feel faint, march on and not grow weary. Lord God, we come before you this November morning to remember. We remember with shame the wars that have marred your world again and again over the last century, and which even now are being fought or being prepared for in parts of the world. We remember with gratitude those who gave their lives so that evil should not prevail. We remember with horror the children who lost their lives or their innocence in the pursuit of victory. We remember with compassion those who still bear the scars, physical, mental, emotional, which will not heal. We remember with determination to learn the lessons that the past has taught us. We remember the continuing grace of God, whose love holds all souls in life and to whom none is dead, but all are alive forever. Woe to the world because of the things that cause people to sin. Such things must come, but woe to the one through whom they come. Lord Jesus, as we hear your words, we look to you for war to cease, for good to triumph, for children to find protection, for wounds to heal, and for the past to be redeemed. Look down on our world in mercy, Good Shepherd, and lead us home.
Thank you. Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you and praise your name, for in perfect faithfulness you have done wonderful things, things planned long ago. You have made the city a heap of rubble, the fortified town a ruin. The foreigner's stronghold, a city no more, it will never be rebuilt. Therefore strong peoples will honour you, cities of ruthless nations will revere you. You have been a refuge for the poor, a refuge for the needy in their distress, a shelter from the storm and a shade from the heat. For the breath of the ruthless is like a storm driving against a wall and like the heat of the desert. You silence the uproar of foreigners. As heat is reduced by the shadow of a cloud, so the song of the ruthless is stilled. On this mountain the Lord Almighty will prepare a feast of rich food for all peoples, a banquet of aged wine, the best of meats and the finest of wines. On this mountain he will destroy the shroud that enfolds all peoples, the sheet that covers all nations. He will swallow up death forever. The Sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces. He will remove his people's disgrace from all the earth. The Lord has spoken. In that day they will say, "Surely this is our God. We trusted in him and he saved us. This is the Lord. We trusted in him. Let us rejoice and be glad in his salvation." May the Lord answer you when you are in distress. May the name of the God of Jacob protect you. May he send you help from the sanctuary and grant you support from Zion. May he remember all your sacrifices and accept your burnt offerings. May he give you the desire of your heart and make all your plans succeed. May we shout for joy over your victory and lift up our banners in the name of our God. May the Lord grant all your requests. Now this I know, the Lord gives victory to his anointed. He answers him from his heavenly sanctuary with the victorious power of his right hand. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord our God. They are brought to their knees and fall, but we rise up and stand firm. Lord, give victory to the King. Answer us when we call. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, as clear as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb, down the middle of the great street of the city. On each side of the river stood the tree of life, bearing 12 crops of fruit, yielding its fruit every month. And the leaves of the tree are for the healing of the nations. No longer will there be any curse. The throne of God and of the Lamb will be in the city, and his servants will serve him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads. There will be no more night. They will not need the light of a lamp or the light of the sun. For the Lord God will give them light, and they will reign for ever and ever.
They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Almighty God, our Father, in memory of those who served and those who died, those who are still serving and those who are dying, may we be better men, women and young people. And in gratitude to you, God our Saviour, may we live as those who are not their own, but those who are bought with a price. In Jesus' name, Amen. God of power and love, bless our country and commonwealth. Give wisdom and strength to the Queen. Govern those who make the laws. Guide those who direct our common life. And grant that together we may fulfil our service for the welfare of the whole people and for your praise and glory. Bless our sailors, soldiers and airmen and women. Defend them in danger. Give them courage to meet all occasions with discipline and loyalty. So may they serve the cause of justice and peace to the honour of your name. Bless our young people. May they never see the flames of war or know the depths of cruelty to which men and women can sink. Grant that in their generation they may be faithful soldiers and servants of Jesus Christ. Bless our friends and those who were our enemies, who suffered or are still suffering from war. Grant that your love may reach out to the wounded, the disabled, the mentally distressed, and those whose faith has been shaken by what they have seen and endured. Comfort all who mourn this day the death of loved ones, and all who this day miss the comradeship of friends. Bless those who are homeless, those who are refugees, those who are hungry, those who have lost their livelihood or security. Help us to pledge ourselves to support, comfort and encourage others, that all may live in a world where evil and poverty are done away and where human life reflects the radiance of your kingdom. Bless those in authority in every land, and give them the wisdom to know and the courage to do what is right. Encourage those who work for peace, who strive to improve international relations, who seek new ways of reconciling people of different race, colour and creed. Bless your church throughout the world, and by your Holy Spirit draw the scattered flock of Christ into a visible unity, and make your church a sign of hope to our divided world. Grant that we who bear your Son's name may be instruments of your peace, bringing peace to our homes, our nation, and our world. And now, rejoicing in the communion of saints, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storms of war into the peace of your presence. And we give you thanks for those whom we have known, whose memory we treasure. May the example of their devotion inspire us, that we may be taught to live by those who learned to die. And at the last, grant that we, being faithful till death, may receive with them the crown of life that never fades through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Saviour. God, grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth and all people, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son and Holy Spirit, be with you all. Amen.